It's falling apart. It's really good. I thought it was gonna be like really overpowering and sweet, but it's like a good amount of sweetness. Did you guys hear that crunch?
Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. And like I said in my first video, I wanted to come back and try a couple more food trucks. So everything here is completely new from the first video except for one thing, and I want to get started right away. So again, I'm in the car because everything is a takeout only service right now. I'm going to start with the one that I mentioned last time that I wanted to try so bad, but it wasn't open until May 1st. So today is the day, and I got two tacos. So this is the first one, and this is their lemongrass chicken. The second one, I got their fish tacos, and it looks so good. I've had this before at the Taco Fest downtown Toronto. I only had one from them, and I still remember that day, and since that they were coming here, I really had to get it again. And then I got this decked out Mexicana fries supreme. I'm gonna go in with the lemongrass chicken. There's a little tiny lime here. I'm so excited. So it's basically like a deconstructed Vietnamese meal, but it's in a form of a taco. So good. Just like how I remembered. And I can't wait for the fish one. It's falling apart. I also got a couple of their house hot sauce, which I've actually never tried before. So I'm gonna try that with the fish. Since the lemongrass already had its own flavor, I don't wanna, you know, cover that. Okay, I'm gonna try it first without the hot sauce. And I'm gonna do the lime again. I love the coleslaw on this. I can't even describe how good this is. You guys have to try it yourself. I just know this is gonna taste so good with the hot sauce. So I've dipped the hot sauce. This beats the lemongrass chicken. The lemongrass chicken is such a classic, but the fish with the coleslaw is just so fresh, and it's so good already without the hot sauce, but with the hot sauce is just an extra bonus to it. One thing I want to say though is that these are pretty expensive. Like one taco is like $9.50 or $11 depending on what you buy, but it is a good size. It's kind of like a burrito size, but for sure for a taco, like, you know, you would usually get like two or three for maybe $16 depending where you go. Okay, one more big bite of this. I'm gonna go back with the chicken. I have to try it with the hot sauce. Really good, but I would rather save the hot sauce for the fish because I can't taste the lemongrass at all. Highly recommend this place. I love this place as much as Tuts in my other video. I really wanted to get Tuts again today, but it was just gonna be too much food. I also remembered last time they didn't forget the sauce. I actually asked for the extra sauce, hence in my other video, I was like looking for it under the fries. But no, if you want extra sauce, just ask for that if you guys do end up going. Now I'm gonna go into this supreme fries, and I'm gonna open this first. Okay, so here I go. So there's a ton of like scallions, tomatoes, onions, and some kind of sauce. It's the Mexicana Supreme fries, I think. Mmm. It has a sweetness to it. Really, really good. It's crunchy because of the scallions, which is a nice, you know, crunch to like soft fries. I'm gonna try it with hot sauce. Really good with the hot sauce. So it's sweet and spicy. I didn't expect the sweet part, but it has a nice tang to it for sure. My nose is starting to get a little bit runny from the hot sauce. This is definitely something to share with other people. Like maybe each get a taco and then have this to be like the shareable. Okay, now I'm gonna try the other things that I got from new places as well. Gonna cleanse the palate first. Everything is so flavorful from these trucks. So the next one is from Six Spice. I wanted to go there last time, but had priorities as well. So this time I got this KFC chicken with also sweet potato fries, and basically it's a Korean fried chicken with mango and sauce all over it. Okay, so I'm gonna try the sweet potato fries and the sauce. The sauce, I don't know what it is, but it's so addicting. It's a type of like aioli sauce, but I don't know what the ingredients are. Spicy and tangy. Okay, I'm gonna try the chicken now. Oh, almost gonna break the container. I'm gonna have to cut this first. Okay, so since I cut it, I'm going to put a bit of everything on like one piece. This mango and the slaw. It's really good. I thought it was gonna be like really overpowering and sweet, but it's like a good amount of sweetness. This is definitely filling and a big piece of chicken. I like this kind of sweetness for a chicken. It's like a little bit spicy, but it's not like spicy. It's just like a hint of it. Okay, I'm gonna hop onto the next one before I get too full. Okay, so I have another order of tacos, except it's birria tacos. I think I'm pronouncing that right, from Food Dudes. And I told you guys in my first video last time that I ordered tacos from another place, Rebozo's, but because the tortilla was a little too flavorful, I couldn't really taste like the sauce or the meat and everything inside. So anyways, I decided to try some birria tacos elsewhere from Food Dudes, and I am super excited. Put that lime on top. This lime is really dry. There's like nothing in it. And here we go. This is my favorite part. It smells so fresh. I can definitely taste like, you know, the filling in this taco a lot more than the other one. It's so beefy. They put so much in here. I'm gonna just dunk it in here. I'm so full. But this is impressive. I'm surprised there's like two layers to it as well. And it's not too like overwhelming or like carby. Still pretty like good. As much as I want to finish this, I am so full. I'm just gonna jump straight to the last one and have my dessert. Can you guys guess what dessert I have? If you guys did watch my last one, then you guys will probably know what it is. And it is a beaver tail. And I got the same flavor as last time. I just love Nutella so much, especially on a beaver tail. It just works so well with like this fried dough, and some parts are crunchy, some parts are chewy, and I just think that it works so well with this. So much Nutella. I was worried because I ate everything else first and that this was gonna get cold, but I put it on the dashboard of the car and it's such a beautiful sunny day today that it was literally warming this up, so it feels like I'm eating this fresh right out of the oven. Or I mean deep fryer. So much better than last time. Last time was like a cold day. For those of you who are new, this is a Canadian thing. A beaver tail. It's literally just deep fried dough. And then you get the toppings on top. Did you guys hear that crunch? See, I said I was full, but now I feel like I can eat this whole thing. I think, or I swear we all know this, that desserts have like a second stomach or a stomach of its own for some reason. Okay. So good. It's not the same as eating like Nutella donut or toast. On a beaver tail, it's just somehow so much yummier. Look at that. That was a close one. I'm wearing white. Last bite to wrap up this vlog. Do you guys dance when you're eating? So good. So this wraps up another video, the second video on this channel, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for also tuning in with me and coming with me to this little food truck area. And of course, if you guys haven't already, it would mean so much to me if you guys would hit that subscribe button, the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video.